Hi, welcome to Marky Mark's Wood Shop. I'm Amber.
And I'm Marky Mark, and this is the wood shop. And today we're going to work on a sign for Amber's garden. Out where we want the letters for a sign, figure that out. We'll just trace them to figure out what we want where and go from there. So we'll get back to you.
We've made a little grid here so we can kind of figure out our spacing for the letters. They are about 1¾ inches tall for the templates I have. So those are the how far apart the lines are, and kind of like your first grade paper. Now we can put the letters on there, hopefully. So we have our lettering laid out approximately where we want them and figured out, you know, if we have enough room for our pictures. So the next step is I'm gonna scroll out all these letters and images will be scrolled out and then glued onto the board. So I've got to copy the letters onto paper and then go over to the scroll saw and scroll them out. So that's what I'm doing now. So we got some scraps that we're gonna glue the letters on and take over to the scroll saw. That's next. Another check's there.
Okay, now that I've got the pictures carved out, I'm going to go ahead and paint the heart first. And then we'll let that dry. Now we'll go ahead and give these guys a base coat of yellow. Just setting it up so that exactly where I'm going to want the letterings glued on for my spacing. At least give me a rough idea. And I think that'll be about do it. Now I'll clean these up a little bit more. And then I will glue these down. And let the glue dry. Oh, that's a little close. I'll take a pencil so I can give myself a little reminder of exactly where I want them. I'll just do a little mark on them because this will actually be painted at one point anyways. So I don't need to worry about sanding off the pencil marking or anything like that. So I'm using the Dremel to carve out the details that I'm going to come back and paint. I'll find a little paintbrush and some black paint and touch this up. Well, so I have some wax paper and all I had was some black spray paint. So I sprayed a little spray paint on there, and I couldn't find a smaller paintbrush, so I got a little piece of rag, and I'm trying to see if I can do that. Otherwise, I might have to get a Q-tip. Okay. I'm gonna have to wait for a Q-tip. So, well, I'm gonna have to go get a Q-tip, so I'll be right back. Well, I got the Q-tip, and that seemed to have done the work job. It's not perfect, but I don't know where my paintbrushes are right now. So, this will have to do. There's the face and the little bee. So, I'll let that dry and then I'll start gluing. Okay, so I took the board outside and I've spray painted it blue. I'm letting that dry. I have some candy apple red that's in paint can, and I'm going to put that on the letters. One of the reasons why I have to paint this is because it's going to be outside. So, I needed a wood that did paint well. And we had Handy. And would hold up with this. And so, we use Poplar, which paints very well. And it should hold up plenty of time. Well, Let me go ahead and finish this up and then I'll... Okay, so we've got them all painted up and it's dried. I've got it set it approximately where I want. I'm going to use this straight board just to keep my letters straight when I put them on.
Make it interesting. Use a warped board. Remember.
Remark reminded me this is supposed to be a funny video. So I guess we'll be funny.
That means you have to laugh at my jokes. I'll let you know. I'll let you know when it's time to laugh. All right, there's the W. We're on a roll. So, what do you do with a blue elephant?
Oh. What?
Tell him a joke.
You're just messing with me. I love you.
I love you too.
Okay, I'm going to glue this up and I'll be right back.
There you go. Here, I'll hold this down for you so it doesn't move.
Thank you. Have a very rough texturing so the glue can fill into the little creases to help let it stick really well.
More surface area. It's all about surface area, like butter. So what do you do with a red elephant?
What?
Pass him the solar cane.
Solar cane? Oh.
The next one should be easy. What do you do with a white elephant?
Give him chalk?
No, give him the suntan lotion.
Yes, I have to listen to elephant jokes. He has many of them. They're special.
I'm saving the best ones for last.
What do you mean?
My elephant jokes.
Uh-oh.
Sexy elephant jokes, huh? Those are the best ones.
And I'm sure everybody wants to know about the dirty elephant jokes. Leave a comment if you want dirty elephant jokes. We can do it on a subsequent video.
Yeah, there we go. Put something over top of it to weigh it down.
Yep.
And we will be back tomorrow when it's dried up.
Well, we got the sign dried up and put a coat of lacquer on it so that it's protected from the weather with the paint. And this is a little special Mother's Day tribute for my mother's memorial garden, rose garden. And there's the sign. Welcome each day with love. And I have some more butterflies and some other things I might put in here. Hi, Loki. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please like, subscribe, leave a message, and have an awesome day.